In today's video, I'm going to show you how to perform the perfect squat, specifically 5 key tips to maintain proper form. Hey guys, welcome back to yet another Tuesday video. I'm Jessica, an athletic therapist teaching you strategies and tools for living a healthier and happier life by staying injury and pain-free. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. No matter if you're performing a bodyweight squat or a loaded front or back squat, there are 5 absolutes when it comes to maintaining and performing a perfect squat. So the first is having an optimal toe angle. So an optimal toe angle is about 5 to 8 degrees slightly turned out. So you'll have your feet slightly wider than shoulder width apart. So having this toe out allows us to engage the glutes a little bit better, as well as to get down a little bit deeper into our squat. Second is to have sufficient foot stability. So we often refer to this as the tripod foot. So what we're looking at is equal weight between these 3 points: your heel, the base of your big toe, and the base of your small toe. So you should have equal amount of pressure on those 3 points when you're performing your squat. Third is to create that external rotation torque in your hips. So still maintaining that foot stability, you're going to torque your hips out into external rotation, engaging those glutes. And then this way, this helps to prevent that knee collapse, what we call valgus knees. And that puts the ACL at a greater and also MCL at a greater risk for injury. So this helps us create a much more stable base. Fourth is hinging from the hips. So when we're going down into a squat, the first thing you should think about is hinging or bending from the hips. So when we're going down into that squat, when we do the hip hinge, we're keeping the center of our body weight through our midfoot. And this is really crucial when we are doing a front squat or a back squat, is that we don't change that position. And our fifth step is maintaining postural integrity. Really, this comes down to core stability. We really want to make sure and keep our trunk engaged and keeping our spine in a neutral position as we go down into our squat and as we come back out of it. And then the other thing too is that if you do find that you have difficulty maintaining that neutral spine when you're going through the squat, I did a video last week on the 3 core fundamental exercises for stabilizing our spine. So if you missed that one, you definitely want to go check that one out. So I'll link it above and I'll put it in the description below for you guys to check out next. So let's quickly run through the 5 movements all at once. So let's get those toes slightly angled out 5 to 8 degrees. Drive those feet down into the floor, spread those toes, creating a larger center of stability for you, and have that pressure between those 3 points that I mentioned before: your big toe, small toe, the base of them, and then the base of your heel. Then drive those knees out, externally rotating from the hip, maintaining that stable foot, and then you're gonna hip hinge and drive your weight down, maintaining that neutral spine. And then push up through those feet and drive yourself back up. Those are the 5 fundamentals. And this last tip that I wanna give you, even though it's not one of the 5 absolutes, it's just one of those common things that I see often done incorrectly, is that when we go down into a squat, maybe there's a mirror in front of you and you end up looking straight up at it as you go down. Well, what that's doing is that's putting your neck into extension and putting your spine into a little bit more extension, and now you're losing that postural integrity that we've talked about. So what I want you to really focus on is think about looking 10 feet in front of you. So it's still looking a little bit more down towards the floor. This will keep your spine in a neutral position, allowing for you to maintain that postural stability and postural integrity without putting yourself at a greater risk for injury with your squats. So there you have it. Those are your 5 absolutes when it comes to maintaining a perfect squat. If you liked this video and found it helpful, please give me a like. If you haven't subscribed already, subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Until next Tuesday, bye guys. Helps us create more stable base. Get the words out. No matter if you're performing a bodyweight squat or you're loaded with a, if you're loaded with it. And we should be slowly. So our center of gravity is really through the center of our body. Duh, center of our body. Okay.